Our next guest, or should I say artists, is the Chicago Children's Choir, under the direction of founder and artistic director Josephine Lee. The choir appeared in Etudes, Opus 3 at the Art Institute of Chicago. We've invited them back this evening, June 1st, for a very special reason, and you're not allowed to answer, Josephine. Does anyone know why June 1st, 2017 might be a good day to have the choir with us? Yes, there you go. No, it's not out here, Josephine. It is?
International Children's Day.
International Children's Day. So we are celebrating along with the rest of the world. And when you think about it, children are nature's form of foresight. As artistic director of the choir, Josephine Lee annually provides programming to 4,600 Chicago youths, making it the nation's premier youth choral organization. She's dedicated her career to intercultural understanding, empowering the choir's singers to become true global citizens. She's a classically trained pianist, conductor, and arranger. She was awarded the Jesse L. Rosenberger Medal in 2014 from the University of Chicago, and just last year she was a collaborator with Chance the Rapper's Grammy Award-winning coloring book. Josephine also happens to be an alumna of Northwestern University, where she holds a master's degree in conducting. Josephine, this is a special year for your organization as well. What is that?
Yes, it's our 60th anniversary season.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I have to be clear that it is as a result of Josephine, how many years ago, taking over the choir?
I started in 1998.
Really taking it to an extraordinary new level. Thank you so much for that, and let's see what you can do.
Thank you.
So, the choir's first selection was composed by Leonard Bernstein, one of the most innovative musical thinkers in musical history. Bernstein was a classical and Broadway composer, pianist, and conductor. Perhaps most importantly, he was a man who had the foresight and will to combine music with education in the form of the groundbreaking Young People's Concerts, broadcasts from the late 1950s to the early 1970s. We often refer to Etudes as an informance, in other words, an informative performance, and that continues to be a tip of the hat to Maestro Bernstein. We're about to enjoy an excerpt from a Bernstein piece commissioned by the Cathedral of Chichester in Sussex, England, and originally entitled Songs of Youth, most appropriate for this date. From the Chichester Psalms by Leonard Bernstein, the Chicago Children's Choir, conducted by Josephine Lee.
Thank you.
So the choir will perform one more selection before our finale, and instead of me telling you about it, I'd like to ask one of the choir members to tell you about it, because it's composed by one of their alumni and composer in residence. Pierce, 17 years old, you're doing some great stuff here. Congratulations. So tell us a little bit about this next piece.
The next piece we're going to be performing is titled We All Live Here. It was written by Mitchell Owens. Mitchell Owens is an alum of the Chicago Children's Choir. He was a part of the organization for 12 years, and after graduating, came back and is now our composer in residence. Although he's written a few of our songs, We All Live Here is especially important to us, because to us it's the most simple way to explain our situation here in our city, in our state, in our country, and in our world. What the song is about is the fact that no matter your sexual orientation, no matter your race, no matter your age, no matter your religion, we all live here, that we're all one people, and that at the end of the day, hate gets us nowhere, and that it's our responsibility to love one another, respect one another, and celebrate one another, and I think that that's something that we can all take into our everyday lives.
Words and music by the Chicago Children's Choir alumnus and composer in residence, Mitchell Owens. We all live here.